Hi. This is a bit of a technical video, but also not. I'm going to show you a cheat soon, but within our nervous system, within our autonomic nervous system, that inner part, that part that most people think we cannot influence, there's two sides. There's something called the sympathetic nervous system, also known as fight or flight. And there's something called the parasympathetic nervous system, also called rest and digest. Now, they're both at the same time functional and dysfunctional. Like if you look at the sympathetic or the fight or flight, you know, like many people are afraid of that, but there's a green part of your stress where your energy is basically, and there's a red part where it becomes too much. And the same goes for the parasympathetic or the rest and digest. Like the positive side of that is to be calm and meditation and stuff like that. And the negative side of that, or the dysfunctional side, is to procrastinate, to not get anything out of your hands, to lie in bed all day, to watch Netflix too much, you know. And we all do it sometimes, and that's okay. So let me show you in a diagram. I'm going to share my sheets. And where I would want to go to is that it all comes down to awareness, you know, like where am I now and where do I want to be? Like I always use the example of in the morning we wake up, we're too much parasympathetic. And this is why we make a cup of coffee. I know most of you, some of you will think like coffee is not good, but you know, it's just an example. And yes, I do drink coffee. So you make a cup of coffee to get like a bit more into that sympathetic, into that fight or flight, you know, to become awake, to have more energy, to be able to focus better. But then if you've drinking too much coffee and in the evening you cannot sleep, you're clearly too much in your sympathetic or fight or flight, and you want to be able to move down to parasympathetic so you're able to sleep. Now, let me show you some sheets. Yeah, first of all, here it is. First of all, this is the way our nervous system looks like. So we have the central nervous system, which is the brain and the spinal cord, and we have the peripheral nervous system, where all from the brain and the spinal cord, all these nerves go to like every organ, every cell of our body. It's this whole network of nerves. Now, within the peripheral, we have like something that is called the somatic nervous system, which I call somatic means movement. Yeah, I call it the conscious nervous system, because if I miss my mother, I pick up my phone, I move to pick up my phone and I call her. And the autonomic is like our inner world, you know, our heartbeat, our hormonal release, our immune response, our inflammation response, our stress response, and opening and widening of your blood vessels. Yes, there's so much. Also the breath, by the way, is autonomic. You know, we don't have to think about breathing. And then if you look at that autonomic nervous system, you can subdivide that into sympathetic, parasympathetic, fight or flight, rest and digest. Now, what I want to show you is first this. This is I just got this from the internet somewhere. And there's more to this, but I just want to show you like first this, this part. If you look at the parasympathetic on the left side, rest and digest, your pupils are going, they constrict. You can see less good. You could say like parasympathetic is when we were cavemen, inside the cave, we know you don't have to memorize, you don't have to be on, you don't have to see that well. And the sympathetic is outside the cave, you have to focus because there could be a tiger, you know, that you have to run for or that you have to fight. Now, that's just an analogy, but let's look at the parasympathetic first. Your pupils constrict, saliva is stimulated. So this is often a question when what I have is when I'm doing a breathing session and people are like, I'm making so much saliva, I have to swallow all the time. That's a sign you are calming down. That's absolutely good. Your heartbeat slows down, kind of you know, like logical, your airways are constricted. This means that you can, your lungs take up less oxygen, simply because if you're calm, you don't need so much oxygen. Your activity of your stomach is stimulated. And this means that more blood is flowing to the gut and there's more going on there. Like after the after dinner dip is a sign of this. You know, you become tired after you've eaten because your stomach is more active. You have less energy. It's very normal. The release of glucose is inhibited. You don't need to move around so much, so your muscles don't need glucose. So the release of glucose is inhibited. It's all, you know, like very much, it's very logical once you understand it. And the intestines, the activity of your intestines is stimulated. It's like the same, the stomach is also stimulated because your gut is active in the rest and digest. Now your bladder is contracted and promote erection of genitals. And this is interesting because if you look at sex, you know, like if we're too stressed, we don't want to have sex. We just don't get aroused. But then if you look on the other side, on the lower other side, it says promote ejaculation and vaginal contraction. Yeah, so to become horny, simply said, you want to be in rest and digest, but then the actual ejaculation or the orgasm, you know, like in general, is like heartbeat up and, you know, like you become warm and stuff like that. And so when we talk about sex, let's talk about sex, baby. It's both. Now let's look at the sympathetic. And after that, I've made a list and you can really make a picture of it, you know, like just a screenshot. I think that would be a great idea because there's more to this than just this, this picture. And then I cannot see the first part. Yeah, so pupils are dilated. You can see better if you're in the sympathetic or fight or flight. You get a dry mouth, salivation inhibited. You know, this is why if you're like started very much, you can get a dry mouth. If you're walking around with a dry mouth, it doesn't mean per se that you're stressed, but it could be. Your heartbeat goes up. Your airways are relaxed. It means that your lungs can take up more oxygen. You know, simply think of the idea that you have to either fight or run for a lion, then your lungs take up more oxygen. So this is, you know, like this is, it's not like all bad. It's not like fight or flight, stress is bad, rest and digest is good. You know, it's both, functional and dysfunctional. Your gut like slows down. So activity of the stomach inhibited. And so is the activity of the intestines. This is why if we are like really too stressed in our daily life, we get gut problems. Then glucose is released simply because you need more energy, you need more fuel, glucose is released. Then epinephrine and norepinephrine is released. It's like adrenaline is released to your body. In the rest and digest, adrenaline goes down. In the fight or flight, adrenaline goes up. Relax the bladder. Well, you know, like, you know, this is why if people are really, really scared, they pee their pants. It could be also just a survival mechanism of our body, because if you lose a kilo, you can run faster for the attacker. And as I just said, you know, the actual orgasm is also a fight or flight or sympathetic act. Now I've made a list because there's a little bit more to this. There it is. So please make a picture of this. And I have two sheets of these. Sympathetic, stress, but also energy. Parasympathetic, calmness, but also procrastination. Both are functional and dysfunctional, and you can use them to your benefit if you are aware of that, of where you are. And that is like the purpose of this video, to become aware, to feel like, oh, I have a dry mouth. Maybe I'm stressed. Or I have saliva production. Oh, I'm calming down. Sympathetic, adrenaline up. Parasympathetic adrenaline down. I'm a little bit, you know, like active now. That's why I talk too fast sometimes. Nobody's perfect. Dry mouth, sympathetic, parasympathetic, and saliva production. Heartbeat up in the sympathetic, heartbeat down, parasympathetic. Blood vessels in the gut contract in the sympathetic simply because the blood flows to your arms and to your legs because you need to either fight or flight, right? And the opposite is for the rest and digest, the parasympathetic. All right, let's go to the next sheet. So I just repeated stress, but also energy and calmness, but also procrastination. Sympathetic nervous system, more oxygen is taken up by the lungs and less in the rest and digest. Also memory-wise, you can memorize things better if you're in the sympathetic. This is why we focus at work. We are like slightly in the sympathetic. You need the energy. This is where focus is. Yeah, but if it's too much, if you work too hard, it can be in the red zone. And this is where, you know, like you, it can be too much and especially too long. So the fight or flight is not bad as long as you're able to go to the opposite at will. So better memory, rest and digest, worse memory. In the sympathetic, you alkalize your body, your blood, because the oxygen goes up. Remember, oxygen levels are higher because the lungs can take up more oxygen and the CO2 relatively goes down. So the ratio oxygen CO2 goes up. This has an alkalizing effect. Alkalizing means less acidic and the pH level goes up. And the opposite in the parasympathetic, acidification. Now it's not bad. You know, here you may think like, hey, wait a minute, then I don't want to be in the parasympathetic because I should alkalize my body. No. If you, let's go to the next first, like it's a bit of the same idea. Inflammation is suppressed in the sympathetic and inflammation goes up in the parasympathetic. And you may think like, wait a minute, you know, like I don't want inflammation in my body. So I want to be in the sympathetic always. Now, this is a mistake we make as human to make things black and white. Both of these are functional as well as dysfunctional. So you could use, you know, like if you are feeling sick and you have like more inflammation in your body, you could use certain techniques to suppress that inflammation. But if you're always in the fight or flight or the sympathetic, then like the inflammation builds up because you keep on suppressing it. And this is when, you know, you have a stressful job, you go on a holiday and week one, you become sick. It's because you finally calm down and all that inflammation goes up. Now, inflammation is not per se a bad thing. It's the same story. You know, like you want to be able to calm down and let that acidification and inflammation get to the surface. You know, that is not a bad thing. Now, another thing is body heat up. You could imagine that, you know, like if you become like really stressed, you start sweating, for example. And when you calm down, your body heat goes down. This is also what I hear often, or what happens often, that through breathing techniques, through breathing session, people get cold. And this is because, you know, you're calming down. It's a great sign. And then the last thing, the vagus nerve, which is a nerve that goes from the brainstem all the way to our gut, is inactive in the sympathetic, so you're less calm. And it's active in the parasympathetic, in the rest and digest. Well, I think this was it. Let me stop sharing. So, You know, like make pictures of these lists, put them in your phone and you can check with yourself because it's all about getting to know yourself better. And if you know you're like, if you don't know that you're stressed, you're further away than if you're aware that you're stressed and you can use techniques. Of course, breathing is a great technique to calm down and the other way around. And through breathing, you can like, that will be the subject of another video because this one is long enough. Through breathing, you can reset that sympathetic, parasympathetic, and get to the middle. So if you are like procrastinating, you can get energy from breathing sessions. And if you're like too stressed, you will calm down from breathing sessions. Okay, let me know how this was for you. Maybe a bit technical, but essential to get to know yourself. And this is my wish. This is what I'm personally working on, is being aware. Where am I? You know, through when I make a video like this, I'm clearly more on the sympathetic. And then if I get like a little bit too much, I start to fall off my own words. And this is where I calm down a little bit. And to be aware where you are and where you want to go to, and have your toolkit of either moving your energy up or moving your stress down, just makes life better. Okay, thank you for your time. And I hope this helped. Please leave a comment if you have a question. And that's it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, it's very much welcome. If you want to have like a email every time I send out a video, which is like at this moment, 3 times a week, you know, I'm growing. It was 1 a week, now it's then 2 a week. And at this moment, I'm at 3 times a week. You can hit that subscribe button. Basically, you get annoyed every time I post a video because you get an email from YouTube that I posted a video. Okay, thanks. Wish you a great day. Bye-bye.